This is a tutorial for Wan2.2 Image2Video. I'm going to chain several short videos together and show you the formula for making as seamless of a transition as possible. There's some leeway to make your own decisions here, but it does work, and I will show you the process. Now I have about 2 minutes for that to appear on the cloud server. I am also rendering locally here on my M2 Ultra on a different computer. This cloud server is actually on a different computer, and I need to stop talking because I'm going to show you how to set up Wan2.2 Image2Video with Lightning. It's up at the top of the basic settings. I'm sorry, up at the top of the settings menu. We're gonna scroll down to community configurations. No, we're not. Actually, we're just gonna type in 2V. And I want Lightning 1.0. And I'm going to swap out the LoRAs for two newer LoRAs. So this is the high noise LoRa. I'm going to swap it for 2510. One of these is the high noise. That's it. I'm going to swap the low noise for the same 2510. Which one is the low noise? Low noise. The only way that I can keep track of these is to keep them alphabetical, and I will explain the differences and why there are two models just as soon as I reset our render. So this is on Draw Things Plus. This is a paid subscription. It does allow video rendering as long as you keep it under the compute units, and we have a little bit of leeway here. I'm going to do the next prompt. I'm gonna give this one just a few more frames. Now we have a little bit of leeway of how many frames we can stick in and still be under the cloud compute, and I just went over. So I think a good range is from about 33 frames to 57 frames. Again, we're just doing this shorter because it fits on the online server, which has unlimited. It is a paid subscription, but it is unlimited. Now let me set that one going. M2 is rendering larger, and I think more frames. How big are you? No, about the same number of frames, maybe a little less. We'll jump back to that in a minute. Now, I said that I would explain, my timer is going, explain why there are two models in Wan2.2. It's because they decided to make the model twice as big, but run under the same constraints. So they split the model in two. It's a pre-model and a refiner. So they have to work together. Well, actually, the low noise can work on its own, but you don't want it. So high noise, that's going to give you the big movement, the big gestures, the camera sweeps, the person spinning around. And low noise is the refiner. It comes afterwards, and it actually starts pretty early. We set it at, that's set at 12. I'm gonna set it at 12.5. And the low noise in the refiner slot stitches together that big motion into smoother motion. It basically smooths over the details, it connects the dots, and then it proceeds to refine the image. So the delicacies of how the final image looks, how hot it is, how underbaked it is probably your LoRa settings. Because with acceleration, We are dumbing this down to 7 steps. I'm still telling you my thing, and keep it in the normal range, except I want... yeah, something like that. Why are you still so high? Okay, 57 is 3.5 seconds. And 33 is 2 seconds. So we have a range. And as you do this, you will definitely want to scramble up those number of frames so it doesn't become too repetitive. Our girl is ready again. What's she going to do this time? She... what did she do? She already looked left and back. I don't just want to make her glance around. How about an expression? Alright, so I think I was talking about the Laura settings. So what's going to happen is... we are chaining the next video from the last frame of the video before. And the way that that's working is I'm simply not playing the video. In other words, I'm doing nothing. As the video finishes rendering, I'm just gonna leave it alone. The last frame of the video is left on the canvas, and that's going to be the start frame for the next video. So I've done that. This is my third, I think. And what I do over here is I've got the same thing set up. I'm just going to drop in my image. Now, this image is too large. Come here. Obviously, so I'm going to trim to the visible region and just paste it right back in without copying over the configuration associated with this photo. And why am I doing portraits and not 16:9? Well, it can do 16:9, of course, and that's fine for YouTube and television. But what I'm doing here with a portrait is I'm getting her head bigger. Her head is a bigger part of the full resolution that I'm rendering, and as you can see, I'm rendering kind of small. Well, 1.2.2 or Draw Things is calling this normal. Yeah, small is even smaller. So I think of this as kind of small, but it's normal for video, I guess. Now I'm going to set my... the high noise, I'm going to bring it down just a scooch to 90%. This is some trial and error. This is also copying other people's configurations. And the low noise, remember that's the refiner that polishes everything off. I'm going to set that about 80. Otherwise, it tends to overcook. Now this, you can obviously tweak this as you want, but we will review some of these videos. And I'm trying to get that transition from video to video as seamless as possible. I think we're gonna get it with 90 and 80 at this size. Where's my size? At this size. This bigger one, I think I've actually slightly changed it because the image stays a little bit cleaner. Oh no, I did not. All right, well, we'll see how that turns out then. I think we are good for one more. And remember, I am just adjusting these number of frames. Even though we're trying to keep that pretty minimal, you will notice it more when it's rhythmic. So I am just picking a different number of frames for each one. Now also, because I'm keeping these times shorter and not rendering routinely 5 and 10 seconds every time, my instructions are basically one instruction per video. So this is a lot easier to handle. in my opinion. I'm just sharing what I do. As we often say, it's not gospel. One more thing that I'm doing here is I set CFG0 on, but I set it to 0. I don't really think it's doing much for me, as opposed to just CFG0 star turned off. But that's what I'm doing. Also, sampler is DDIM trailing. Our big guy is finished. I'm gonna go ahead and play this video. So you see the problem if you go ahead and play the videos. So playing the video, he's got a great face. It's very close to his face, so it is actually keeping a lot of details and skin texture. Honestly, that's the reason to do a portrait, is to make the face as big as possible, to keep all the details that you can. Otherwise, one just really likes to smooth off. When you do 16:9, a person's face is just a small square inside a big field that's mostly background. And while we're trying this out and learning, I'm just gonna concentrate right on a big old face. When we play it, it plays through once and then resets. So to catch it on that last frame, to start the next image to image, I have to pause it and drag it to the end. Now it's on the last frame and I can do his next thing. What's he gonna do? I'd say, she's still rendering. She's upset and she's not liking this at all. Maybe that will be our last frame and then we'll go ahead and look at these videos. So I'm gonna show you one last trick. This is the machine settings, which a normal program would call preferences, but DrawThings calls it the machine settings, which sounds very exotic. What I want to change, or make sure that you change, is video export format, and the options are ProRes 444, which is extremely overkill, at least until we have alpha channel video. ProRes 422 HQ, that's more than good enough for editing. And H.264, which is great for sharing online. It's still high quality, and you can get away with editing this, but it's not as pristine as ProRes. But with that, I think we are almost done. What I choose is DDIM trailing. And shift, what did I use for shift? Just to make sure that I am not lying to you. Down here I left shift at 3. It defaults to 5. If I had a big scene with small people and I wanted very clean motion, in other words, the figures on the screen were taking up a small amount of pixels, I might want to bump this really high, maybe even higher than the user interface allows, and I would write maybe shift as 12 and paste that in. I won't actually show you that right now because we are almost done with this tutorial. I'm just going to step into the version history room. We have our 4 videos here displayed. I am right-clicking, select multiple, shift-click. I have all 4 selected. Right-click again, export as video. And now it's writing all 4 of these videos in order as one video file. I'm just gonna give it a name and then we'll go check it out. Where is this? I need to edit this video down. What did I just call it? Bing bing! And here we are. Oh, Now I'm gonna get QuickTime to loop this. And see if you can spot the transitions. You probably can, because there's very minimal movement. And there was one little flash there. And another little flash, so I'm not getting them entirely seamlessly, but you see that her movement is very seamless and natural and easy to control because we're keeping the prompts short. So feel free to go back through and micro-adjust those Laura strengths. I think that's better than adjusting the step strength, because we can make very fine adjustments through the Laura's. And because there are two Laura's, it's just twice as complicated. This is why I've avoided this tutorial for up to now, but Straight P has been keeping me honest, so this tutorial is for you. And happy rendering. I will talk to you next time. There are more big tutorials coming up, but I'm trying to keep this one easy and light. All right, I will see you next time, kids. Have fun rendering, and no, that's it. Have fun rendering, that's all. Bye.